Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog with the summary of the Solo Negocios bulletin for today, June the 15th, 2018, with the foreign exchange market, in specific for Mexico. Now, what happened today is that the peso got appreciated, even with the whole monetary week being so tense, and obviously the trade war initiated by the United States. To begin with, we had this Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index increased by 0.01%, given the divergent monetary policies between the developed countries. To begin, on Wednesday, the Federal Reserve increased its rate 25 basis points, and the press conference made by Jerome Powell stated basically that there is becoming an acceleration for the normalization of the interest rate in the United States. In second place, the Bank of China didn't increase its rate, given a potential, or as it was interpreted by the market, a potential deceleration of its economy. Also, the Central Bank of Europe, they decided to not move the rates, but stayed at a date to begin with the elimination of purchases, bond purchases, which provides liquidity to the markets. This will occur in December 2018, and by June 2019, they're planning to begin increasing their rate. We'll see if it happens. But basically, we're talking about three different positions. Federal Reserve, with an economy growing solidly, or greatly, as Jerome Powell said, well, they did increase their rate. China didn't, because they're decelerating their economy. And Europe didn't, but fixed rates, dates specifically for the purchase of bonds, and when they are going to be moving the rate. So they are like in the middle of these rounds of deceleration or acceleration. Also, we have information regarding the Bank of Japan. Today, they didn't move the rate, and they basically said that their inflation targets are not being met, and they're still in this kind of deflationary position. Although there's growth in their economy and some sort of inflationary movements, the truth is that their scenario is worse even in this position of deflation. So these divergent positions brought speculative markets to move the peso up today, at least in the interbank dollar and in the banking system. Also, USA showed three different economic indicators. One of them is the manufacturing activity grew more than expected. Industrial production went down, which was a surprise. And the consumer confidence indicator from the University of Michigan went up more than expected. So this implies that US economy is growing. Let me make a point here. William Dudley was the president of the Federal Reserve of New York, and he decided today to turn down his position. Well, he decided this a while ago, but this was the last day of his job. And he mentioned things that were not mentioned by Jerome Powell on Wednesday. Jerome Powell was asked in the press conference if he had information or a comment on the position of the trade and tariffs and stuff like that from the United States to the rest of the world, initiating a trade war, and he didn't want to mention over that topic. William Dudley specifically told today that that trade war and that protectionism, also and along with the immigration policy of the United States, will bring damage to their economy. He believes that the economy will keep growing until 2020, given the incentive that is being provided by the fiscal or tax reform in the United States, but he's saying that the potential risks of this trade war will bring problems in terms of inflation to the United States. And the immigration policies that is restrictive right now will bring a diminishing of the productive labor, productivity basically, in the United States. So this is like an advice for the president, or a kind of important position against his policies. In other terms, also the trade war began also today, or began a while ago, but the truth is that today the US applied $50 billion of tariffs to China, and they are keeping another set of $100 billion pending, given other negotiations. China simply said there will bring reprisals to this position. Oil went down. They are expecting, the market is expecting what will happen with the OPEC agreement. They are divided. Some countries like Saudi Arabia or Russia are in favor or diminishing the cutting agreement, but other countries like Iran and Iraq are not in favor of this. Banco de Mexico exposed exchange hedges, and they were demanded 5.53 times the $200 million offered. So there seems to be some sort of volatility. Support for the Mexican peso is 20 pesos with 20 cents per dollar. Resistance, 21 pesos per dollar in the wholesale market. The spread in the banks went down a little bit, 3 cents. And this shows that there is erratic information and volatility, basically. Well, this is the whole information we have for today. We expect you to see you again on Monday. And we'll have a great weekend. Thank you.